Welcome all. Today we are going to see how to enter a clean room. What is clean room? That is the first question that will come to everyone's mind. Clean room is a controlled environment in a confined space which is developed to ensure that there are almost minimal dust particles or impurities in the surrounding area. Why this is done? This is done to ensure that the kind of fabrication that we do at micron scale or at nano scale is done without any kind of contamination on the devices. Depending upon the amount of contamination, clean rooms are classified. The classification is based on the fact how many particles greater than 0.5 micron are present in a cubic meter. So if there are 100 particles in a cubic meter greater than the size of 0.5 micron, it will be called as class 100. Similarly, class 1000 and class 10,000. The clean room that we are going to enter now is class 1000 to class 10,000. So now let us see how to enter a clean room, because most of the people who are working in the field of microfabrication or nanofabrication must know how to enter a clean room. So now my colleague will show what is the process. So the first step to enter a clean room is to remove your shoes. This reduces the extent of contamination. And now you can see as he is keeping the shoes in a designated place. After removing the shoes, the next step is to access the clean room using a biometric entry. And now the process next to this is donning of the clean room gown. Donning of the clean room gown is a process that requires sequential steps to be followed strictly. The first step to wear is mask. As you can see, my colleague is wearing another mask on top of the existing mask due to COVID protocols. Then the next step is to wear a hairnet. Hairnet is used to prevent any kind of particle or hair falling onto a device or on the clean room floor. Next step is to wear shoe covers. Shoe covers are meant to prevent any kind of dust particles from our feet when we are entering the premise of the clean room. After wearing shoe covers, the next step is to don the clean room gown. Clean room gowns is the next step towards the clean room entry. These gowns are specially dedicated gowns or coverall suits designed for working in a clean room environment. They do not generate any kind of dust or cloth-like particle or fiber-like particles. They also are static protected, static charge protected. Now my colleague is showing with the process of wearing a clean room gown. The clean room gown is the second last step, after which the last step of entering the clean room is wearing gloves. There are special gloves of different types which are out of the scope of this particular session, but the first and the foremost protection layer for hands is latex gloves. Before we wear the gloves, the step which is required to be completed is wearing clean room shoes. As you can see, my colleague is wearing a static charge protected clean room shoes. Now the next step will be to wear clean room gloves. These are nitrile gloves which have resistant to weak chemicals. These gloves can be used while working with solvents like acetone or IPA, and they are powder free, which means they do not generate any kind of dust particles even on the hand when they are worn. So till now we have seen how to wear a clean room gown, how to wear different parts which are required to be used in order to cover maximum body parts exposed. All this process in all is required to reduce the number of dust particles generated as you enter the clean room. So this is how clean room entry is made. So the final step before one enters the clean room is to step on a sticky mat. This is a mat which is put up dedicatedly at that particular spot just before entering the clean room, so that whatever dust particles are there on the shoes are taken care of. This is how we enter a clean room. So now we will see how to remove the clean room, or how to remove clean room gown or exit a clean room. The process is also called doffing of the gown. My colleague will now demonstrate the process. The first step is to remove the gloves, as these are the most contaminated accessory that a clean room user wears. Since we come in contact of various chemicals, the first and the foremost step should be removal of the gloves, followed by removal of the clean room gown. Before we don the clean room gown, as we can see, the next two steps are to remove the hairnet and the mask. The next step is now to remove the clean room gown. Clean room gowns should be worn by a single user, and the same gown should not be worn by another user, and it should be placed at a designated place from where it was taken. These are some clean room disciplines that one has to follow in order to maintain the cleanliness of the clean room and also to prevent any kind of cross contamination. The whole idea of using a dedicated gown is to prevent the cross contamination, which is one of the major causes of device failure in a clean room environment. So as we can see, the clean room gown is being placed at the designated place from where it was taken. The final step before exiting the clean room is to remove the shoe cover. It is important to remove the shoe cover after crossing the bench. Bench acts as a barrier to prevent any kind of dust from the socks or from the feet of the user. Again, the exit of the clean room can be done by pressing the exit button and then closing the door. So this is how we can exit a clean room.